If you just bought a new 14 or 16 inch MacBook Pro, let me share with you my must-have accessories for these new MacBooks. And I'm not gonna talk about obvious things such as AirPods, but things that will actually work well, be cost-effective, and be smart choices. Now, let's go ahead and start out with something that I was not expecting to be this good, and this is this moffed sleeve for your MacBook. First off, it's not that expensive, especially compared to Apple's $180 sleeve, and it is multi-purpose. So not only will it protect your Mac, keep it safe from scratches, dings, but inside there is a little section for a little kind of secondary sleeve with this neoprene. So if you go ahead and toss something in, say like this SSD that we're gonna talk about, it will actually flex out so you still have proper amounts of room for your Mac. There's actually a little pocket here for identification if you wanna put a little card in. And along with that, it actually functions as a stand. So like a lot of moffed products, it's kind of like a little bit of origami where you can go ahead and pop a section up, you can open up your Mac, and it will actually hold it up. And there's two different angles that you can set it up at. So if you wanna get a little bit higher, you don't wanna be scrunching down, I can literally set it up like this and use my Mac and type and have a nice ergonomic setup, all for the low price of about 50 bucks. Now with that, if you wanna use your Mac in clamshell mode, one thing that I absolutely love is this 12 South Arc stand. It's very high quality, it matches the colors, and it allows you to set up your Mac next to your monitor if you're gonna go in clamshell mode, and it will sit vertically out of the way with the vents opened up right here for proper airflow, and then you can grab your keyboard and your mouse and use your Mac basically like a desktop. Now, of course, if you wanna buy a keyboard or a mouse, I would say grab yourself Apple's Magic Mouse. Now, some people don't love them because one, they're expensive, the charge port is at the bottom here, so I do have an alternative for you. But as far as the keyboard, I would grab the Magic Keyboard just because it's so slim and small. I would opt for the version that does have Touch ID because it is very convenient if your Mac is in a clamshell setup to be able to have Touch ID still. So I'd still buy Apple's keyboard and the battery life is incredible. But if you're somebody that's not gonna set it up this way, you just wanna have a mouse that you can use, you can throw in your bag for those occasions, I would check out this little mouse right here. It looks kind of like a Magic Mouse, doesn't have that touch surface, but it's lightweight, it's Bluetooth, the charging plug is right here in the front, not at the bottom. It only costs you 15 bucks. It works really well. I'll have that link down below along with everything else that I'm showing you guys. Now, the next thing is something that everybody needs, and that is a dongle. Now, I have three in front of me depending on your budget and your needs. Let's start out with this one in the center because it only costs 15 bucks. And it has four USB-A ports. Now, I took my time researching which one of these are the best because a lot of them out there are very inexpensive, but the performance is poor. This Inatech, all four of these USB-A ports are 10 gigabit per second. Some out there, most of them are actually half speed at 5. Some are USB 2, which is terrible. Now, another thing you guys have to keep in mind is that you wanna get one with a cable. Those ones that show up that they're flush on the side and attach, if you buy one of those, you're gonna end up blocking your ports over here, your headphone jack, and part of your MagSafe charger. So you do not wanna buy one of those. There's none on the market right now that are designed properly for these. So get one with a cable. Now, if you wanna have a little bit more capability, you can pick this one right here from Inatech for 30 bucks. So it's double the price, but what you get is not only do you have three USB-A ports, you also get an HDMI and a USB Type-C. Now, this USB Type-C can allow for charging, meaning if you wanna use USB C charging and you take up one of your ports, you will get that access back to charge up to 100 watts, by the way. A lot of them are much slower. And you have an HDMI. Now, the MacBooks have an HDMI built in, but if you're gonna use this adapter for multiple different devices, maybe another Mac or maybe an iPad, you have the capability, and this is full 4K 60. So no weak HDMI ports with these adapters. Now, if you wanna spend a little bit more money, we have this charge-in one, which comes in at 85 bucks, and you also have 10 gigabit per second USB-A ports, full speed HDR 4K 60 HDMI, a headphone jack, which is great if you're gonna plug it into an iPad, and we have Ethernet at the bottom, and then on the other side, we also have a USB Type-C that is fast, and we have two SD card slots. So the MacBook does have an SD card slot, but it is not full performance. It's close, 250 megabytes per second, but this one runs at about 320, and we have a micro SD that's also UHS 2 full performance. So if you want to get an ultimate one, this is the one to go for. Now, for those of you guys that are doing the desktop setups, I have to show you guys this OWC dock. A lot of people out there think if you're buying a dock, you're gonna spend 300 bucks, 400 bucks. This guy comes in at 180, and even though it doesn't have an SD card reader or an HDMI built in, obviously your Mac already has that. So if you're somebody that just wants a USB-A that's full speed, and you're gonna be taking one USB Type-C Thunderbolt port and it'll be transferring that to three. And because the new MacBooks use Thunderbolt 4, all of these ports here will run at full speed because of how it's set up. So I tested using my monitor, my NAS that's Thunderbolt, and then the Thunderbolt drive that I have here, and I had no slowdowns at all. So if you have Thunderbolt devices, you wanna hook up a monitor through that, and a couple things, you guys can pick this up. I really, really like it. Now, along with that, if you bought a new MacBook, unless you went crazy and you bought the 8 terabyte one, chances are you're gonna need a little bit more storage. And this Sabrent is the one that I recommend to everybody for two reasons, or you could say even three. First one is the price. It's very well priced, but along with that, it is a Thunderbolt drive. So it's not a USB Type-C 5 gigabit or 10 gigabit. You can have over 2000 megabyte per second transfers. Now, not only that, most Thunderbolt drives, they actually only work with Thunderbolt. Whereas this one, if you go ahead and decide to hook it up, say through one of these adapters, or if you hook it up to a Windows PC or something that does not have Thunderbolt, it will still work with full speed 10 gigabit per second USB Type-C. So it is very flexible. So if you buy one, I would pick up one of these. And these go all the way up to, I think, 16 terabytes now. They are insane. And the storage costs a lot less. Now, the last thing that I wanna show you guys is a power bank. So you guys may know that these MacBooks, they have USB Type-C charging, so you don't have to use the MagSafe port. And because they're running on Apple Silicon and the GPU and CPUs use so little power, you could actually pick up one of these power packs, and while you're doing video editing, photo editing, not only will it keep your battery from dying, it will actually charge up at the same time. Now, I will link a couple down below that I prefer. I would say at least get a 65 watt. For most occasions, it will power up your Mac and charge it. Or if you want to go all out and make sure there's no throttling or slowdowns, pick up one that is 100 watts. And then, especially if you got a 14-inch model, you don't have to worry about battery life and not having as much as a 16-inch MacBook Pro. So there you guys go. Those are my top accessories, the must-haves for your brand new MacBook. All the links are down below. Go ahead and check them out. And if you have any others that you suggest, go ahead and comment down below as well. This has been Max. Click above to subscribe to help us reach our goal of 1 million subscribers. Check out one of those great videos right over there. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.